Hey, what's up, YouTubers? So today, Apple announced their OS X El Capitan. So I'm just about to update the system that I normally use betas on, and I want to run a Geekbench before and after. So just to give you a quick review of my MacBook, if some of you are new here and don't know my specs, this is a 2.9 gigahertz Intel i7. This is an 8 GB model, and I have the Intel HD 4000 with a gig of RAM for graphics. Now I'm going to run a 64-bit just as a base. I just want to point out that I am using ScreenFlow to record this video, so obviously performance won't be at the absolute max. I will run the exact same conditions once we get into the upgraded system. So you can kind of base it on just overall performance of how my Mac is handling recording this while doing a Geekbench. Optimally, you would want to or do your Geekbench with no applications running. Of course, in this case, I just want to do a quick comparison of the performance of the first beta. So I'll be quiet now and we'll just let this finish. Alright guys, so you can see here that my MacBook has finished its Geekbench. So just in relative comparison to the scores I've had without running any applications, this is very close. So we'll remember these scores, I'll save them here, and we can take a look at once we upgrade to OS El Capitan what the comparison just differences overall performance. I mean, we'll give it that, it is a beta. So, I mean, this is beta 1. Apple just released this a few hours ago. So, just keep that in mind. I will continue to do performance reviews as the betas go along. Betas are only intended for developers as is. So, we're not expecting anything, to be outrageously awesome right off the hop. But that's what Apple has these grace periods for. So, we'll see you guys after the upgrade. Stay tuned. What's up, YouTube? So I am back here on El Capitan. My MacBook is finished updating and I got my Geekbench back open here. So just to show you guys here, I am on the El Capitan 10.11, build number 15A or 178W. I'm experiencing a UI glitch right now. Mine still says Yosemite. Anyways, let's run the Geekbench at 64-bit and see how much more improvement, just stock, if any, are we even going to see performance-wise without upgrading any hardware here. So just Geekbench on each performance. Again, I am running ScreenFlow in the background, so take into consideration that my MacBook is not just recording the screen, but it's also recording me speaking to you now. So I'll be quiet, and this can speed up, and we'll see what the results are. So it actually appears that we are running relatively the same on each side. So more of maybe optimization within applications, we'll see. But your overall performance in a Geekbench will look pretty much the same. It's pretty cool to see that even as the first beta, there's still that this kind of stability. So I think Apple has done a decent job. I'm going to now start digging into El Capitan here and see what I can find, and we'll see you guys again in the next video. Thanks for watching. Cheers.